Tonight, live from the Shrine Auditorium in Los Angeles, you're invited to the 11th Annual Screen Actors Guild Awards. Join these actors as they honor the year's greatest performances in film and television. Starting the party with Tattinger Champagne is Ricardo Antonio Chavira from Desperate Housewives. It's Will and Grace nominee Megan Mullally. From Finding Neverland, Freddie Highmore. Patricia Heaton from Everybody Loves Raymond. Star of 24, Kiefer Sutherland. Nominated tonight, the cast of The Sopranos. He'll receive tonight's Lifetime Achievement Award, James Garner. Aviator star Cate Blanchett and Portia de Rossi from Arrested Development. Deborah Messing, nominee from Will and Grace. Sean Hayes lending a hand to Allison Janney. Sex and the City's Sarah Jessica Parker. Presenter Tim Robbins and nominee Don Cheadle. Desperate Housewives Eva Longoria. Star of Kinsey Laura Linney. Alias nominee Jennifer Garner is here. Nominee Jeffrey Rush. Presenting tonight Dennis Franz. It's Cloris Leachman with Ellen DeGeneres. Lion in Winter nominee Glenn Close. Anthony LaPaglia from Without a Trace. First-time nominee Terry Hatcher. Screen Actors Guild President Melissa Gilbert. The ladies from 6 Feet Under. Million Dollar Baby nominee Morgan Freeman. Being Julia nominee Annette Bening and Warren Beatty. And now, join us for the celebration of the Screen Actors Guild Awards.
I was out of work, and I got a job in front of a gas station, dancing in the street, 6 straight hours in the sun. It was great, except I didn't know anything about makeup. So I painted 2 big white eyes and a big red mouth on myself. And later, when I went to wash it off, I found out that the sun had permanently burned a clown face onto my skin. I'm Alan Alda. I'm an actor.
When I was in the 6th grade, I told my mother that I wanted to be an actress, and she said that I would grow out of it. Mom, it hasn't happened yet. I'm Marcia Cross, and I'm an actor.
I turned down 3 promotions for a manager at a grocery store to go to the American Academy of Dramatic Arts. I'm Dennis Haysbert. I'm an actor.
When I was a young girl, I rode the subway from our apartment in Astoria, Queens, to Broadway and 46th Street, the High School of Performing Arts. I'm still on that journey. My name is Jessica Walter, and I'm an actor.
I can wait tables, I can drive a cab, I can't file and I can't type. I'm John Spencer and I'm an actor.
I was an apprentice at Summer Stock for 3 solid years where I built the sets, made the wardrobes, and was best known for my ability to clean a bathroom. My name is Jennifer Garner and I'm an actor.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Annette Bening and Morgan Freeman.
It's been a great year for actors. They lit up the screen in biographies, action pictures, love stories.
And tonight we welcome all of you to celebrate the outstanding actors who brought those stories to life.
This year, television at its finest continued to explore the endless puzzle of the human heart.
And nowhere was that exploration more generous than in the performances of these 5 women.
The nominees for outstanding performance by a female actor in a television movie or miniseries are
Glenn Close, The Lion in Winter.
We're locked in for another year. 4 seasons more. What a desolation. What a life's work.
Patricia Heaton, Neil Simon's The Goodbye Girl.
Or stronger in my life. And someone's actually about to walk out that door and I'm not crumbling into a million pieces. I mean, God, that just...
Kiki Palmer, The Wolf Cat.
You think I want to be here? You think this is fun for me? Hanging out with Mr. Yakety Yak? She's coming back. She always comes back.
Hilary Swank, Iron-Jawed Angels.
I just wonder what needs to be explained. It should be very clear.
Charlize Theron, The Life and Death of Peter Sellers.
Ah, child. I've always given you room for what you needed.
And the actor goes to Glenn Close.
This is the third win for Glenn Close as Outstanding Female Actor in a TV movie.
Thank you so much. It means the world to me to get this award from my peers. I adore what I do. I think it's the most wonderful profession in the world. And I want to share it with my collaborators, every single one of them, on the amazing experience that was Lion in Winter. It was daunting taking on a role word for word that was made iconic by the great Katharine Hepburn, who won an Oscar for it. But I have to tell you a story very quickly. When I was a senior in college at William & Mary, I was painting scenery backstage, and the Dick Cavett interview with Hepburn, the only time she was ever on television, happened to be playing. And so I knew that I'd wanted to be an actress, but something happened to me that night watching her, and I said to myself, if that's what you want to be, do it. And the next day, I went to the office of the head of the theater department. I asked to be nominated for a series of national auditions. I ended up that fall with my first job as an understudy on Broadway. And later, when Hepburn was celebrated at the Kennedy Center Honors, I was one of the group of artists that helped celebrate her. And she came backstage, which was very rare. And I was coerced into telling her this story. And so I kind of stuttered it, you know, about how she had a real impact and was the reason why I got my first job. And days later, I received this letter, which hangs on a wall in my house in a place of honor. And what she wrote to me was this: I'm glad I persuaded you, when you were a mere child, to join this terrible profession, this terrifying profession. And let's face it, this delicious way to spend your life. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, Freddie Highmore.
Hello, everyone. Thank you for inviting me. I'm here today to tell you a bit about the first feature film nominated for the Ensemble Cast Award, Finding Neverland. In the movie, the famous playwright J.M. Barrie is played by Johnny Depp. He meets Sylvia Llewellyn Davies, my mum, played by Kate Winslet. As the story unfolds, Barrie becomes a magical friend of the family, and we become his inspiration for the timeless legend of Peter Pan.
What's it like? Neverland.
One day I'll take you there.
Thank you.
Please welcome Kira Sedgwick and Topher Grace.
Hi.
Sir Laurence Olivier had this to say about acting. It's not so much a matter of being real. Acting is an illusion, a matter of magic.
And these accomplished actors found the magic in five riveting portrayals for the small screen. The nominees for Outstanding Male Actor in a Television Movie or Miniseries are...
Jamie Foxx, Redemption.
If I have those children so they'll have a chance to grow up and be somebody, be a husband or a wife, have a chance to dream and make some of those dreams come true, I still got fight in me.
William H. Macy, The Wool Cat.
I'd move here. She would live with me. But legally...
How dare you? After all you put us through.
Barry Pepper, 3, The Dale Earnhardt Story.
Please go home if you change your mind.
Jeffrey Rush, The Life and Death of Peter Sellers.
Ah, yes. Switzerland, of course.
Here, Jill.
John Voight, Mitch Albom's The Five People You Meet in Heaven.
I forgive you.
And the actor goes to...
Jeffrey Rush.
Jeffrey Rush won an actor for his role in the feature film Shine. This is his first win for a television movie.
Thank you very much. I don't know how you calibrate acting. I can't define for myself how you do it or how it turns out, but to be nominated by the Guild in such great company is a really thrilling benchmark. I delude myself actually into thinking that when I'm naked, I look like this guy. I love that he's called the actor and he's not the talent or the celebrity or the soundbiter or the whore or all of the things that we sometimes, you know, have to succumb to. As Glenn said, I mean, I just love this job. I love this profession. I love the vast heritage of it. And when you work with people like Charlize and Emily and John Lithgow, Stanley Tucci, Miriam Margolyes, you become just so much more acutely aware of that. Thank you, Stephen Hopkins, my director, for teasing us all into a wonderful state of play. And thank you, Peter Sellers, just for the extreme pleasure of being able to watch all of your movies. Thank you.
When the Screen Actors Guild Awards return, Jamie Foxx, Kerry Washington, Kiefer Sutherland, and Rosario Dawson, plus Dennis Franz help celebrate the many ways of being an actor. TNT's presentation of the 11th Annual Screen Actors Guild Awards is brought to you by Subaru, designed from the ground up with symmetrical all-wheel drive, standard. Ladies and gentlemen, Kerry Washington and Jamie Foxx.
I want you to know that before he left us, the King of Soul, the man himself, Ray Charles, got a chance to view the scrim. Is this tape? Yeah, just start it over.
Music.
I want you to know that before he left us, the King of Soul attended a screening of Ray and viewed the film in his own way. the second film nominated for
Hello.
Man, it seems like we've been here before, but I want you to know
what?
That before he left us, the King of Soul attended a screening of Ray,
mm-hmm.
tonight's second film, nominated for Ensemble Cast.
Not only did Mr. Charles see the film, which is how he would have wanted us to say it, but with pride and gratitude, he gave us his blessing to share his film with the world.
Our enormously talented family of actors portrayed his loving mother, his wife, Della B, and his ladies of the road.
Plus the many devoted mentors and musicians who became a part of Ray's gifted and legendary life.
You go home and sleep it off.
Why don't you make me leave then, sucker? Teach you to treat me like some piece of meat. No, I ain't shutting up, Pat.
Should we get in there?
No.
Get them all out of
here
right now.
People have to make me leave if
you
want me to go.
You know what? You ain't got to shut up. I'll tell you what, Jeff. Get all of them out of here.
Everyone. See? You a cold-ass bastard. No, let go of me, Jeff. You a cold-ass bastard, Ray.
Please welcome Rosario Dawson and Kiefer Sutherland.
The artist we honor here tonight for outstanding female actor in a supporting role all depicted characters that were bold, bright, and outspoken.
They played a young Kate Hepburn, a wise alcoholic grandmother, the wife of Alfred Kinsey, a spirited divorcee, and a valiant mother struggling to protect her family.
Here are the nominees.
Kate Blanchett, The Aviator.
Very careful not to let people in, or they'll make us into freaks.
They can't get in here, we're safe.
They can always get in.
Cloris Leachman, Spanglish.
You are going to lose your husband if you don't stop what you are doing. And you will never find someone as good.
Laura Linney, Kinsey.
Other men, because I love you, and I don't want to hurt you.
But what if it didn't hurt me?
Then I'd be hurt.
Virginia Madsen, Sideways.
Constantly evolving and gaining complexity. That is until it peaks. Like you're 61.
Sophie Okonedo, Hotel Rwanda.
Don't worry. It's okay.
It's okay.
And the actor goes to Kate Blanchett.
Kate Blanchett's first award in the supporting actor category. She's also nominated tonight for ensemble cast in The Aviator.
Thank you. I so didn't expect this. I wore a really tight dress that's very ungracious walking up those stairs. Thank you very much. I sort of don't know where to begin. Playing Katharine Hepburn, I absolutely did not expect to be standing here in front of you all. But Hepburn aside, I actually would like to say, as an actor coming from another country to this country, I am so astounded and amazed and grateful at the power of the SAG union and what it does for its members. And And I hope that other countries, my own included, you know, is inspired by that. I think it's incredible. So thank you very much. I think the head, shoulders, knees and toes of this belong to Martin Scorsese, who led us all and gave us great courage. I'm shaking. Thank you so much. And to Leonardo and to Graham King, who was so incredibly welcoming, to Morag Ross, who painted every single freckle on my face, and everyone, because it's an absolute team effort, and to Tim Monick. I don't know where to begin. I'm overwhelmed. Thank you so much.
Ladies and gentlemen, Dennis Franz.
I'm often asked, just who votes for Screen Actors Guild Awards? The answer is, we all do. You may not know their names, but our guild is full of dedicated professionals. From stunt work to voiceover characters, their highly skilled talents are essential to the creation of both film and television. Together, they represent the spirit of collaboration and the joy of acting at its best.
I'm Debbie Evans, and I'm a stunt woman, and I'm also a SAG member. Matrix Reloaded was an awesome experience. I drove the Ducati with traffic, against traffic. I drove a car underneath a moving semi on Fast and Furious. The truck was swerving, and then I just picked a moment and went underneath it. And then I flipped the car off the side of the road. I say that I do car acting and motorcycle acting, and people laugh at me, but it's true.
Puppetry is acting with your hands, basically, or talking with your hands, or providing character with your hands.
I think not, baby puppy. It is you who is in trouble.
Being an actor with a specialty like puppetry allows me to be multiple different characters. I'm not typecast in my physical body type. In the movie Men in Black, the worm guys were provided by 7 or 8 SAG puppeteers who made those 4 or 5 characters come to life. Whatever the industry can dream of, we're right there dreaming it with them and providing believable characters that live and breathe on film and television.
I'm John West, and I'm a singer and a member of the Screen Actors Guild. We work in collaboration with the producer and the composer to make sure that the action on the screen is brought to life in its most powerful way. The kind of work that we do covers the gamut from R&B to classical to pop and everything in between. Just makes us feel absolutely incredible to know that we did a job well.
I'm Jim Cummings, and I do voiceover.
And where there are bees.
I've been blessed to be the voice of Winnie the Pooh for almost 20 years now.
You want to go bouncing with me?
Well, and I've been bouncing around as Tigger for a while. A lot of times they'll say to me, gosh, you're really so good, you know, you should try acting. I'm thinking, hold on, I'm thesping my little guts out over here, come on.
To be, or...
Taz, Tasmanian Devil.
Taz, say hi, everybody.
Billy Conscious, SAG member since 1994. As a background actor in NYPD Blue, my responsibilities on the set are to create the activity in a station house. As a background actor, we have to perform, we have to act. We have to create a whole other story going on behind what's actually going on. When you're a SAG member, you're a professional, you're relied on doing a job, and people in the production company expect a level of professionalism in your job.
And cut.
I'm Sharon Ferguson, and I'm a dancer. Dancing is a form of acting. It's a way of expressing yourself with your body without words. I like to take people on a ride. I like to take people on adventures. And with dance, you can do that. I remember the day I got my SAG card. I was like, yes! I did it. I felt so proud of myself that I had done it.
There's singers, there's dancers, there's puppeteers, there's stunt people, the background actors, there are VO actors, voiceover actors, and you probably don't even know our names, but we're all actors, and we're out there.
The Screen Actors Guild Awards continue with Ellen DeGeneres, Paul Giamatti, plus Outstanding Male and Female Actor in a Comedy Series. Please welcome Terry Polo and John Stamos.
Charlie Chaplin observed, "A day without laughter is a day wasted."
Oh, but Charlie, that's never the case whenever these actors make an appearance.
The nominees for Outstanding Male Actor in a Comedy Series are...
Jason Bateman, Arrested Development.
Do you have a wife?
Yeah, but she's dead.
Oh. Have you ever been married?
Yeah, she died.
John Hayes, Will and Grace.
Please take a memo, Miss Walker. Dear employees, from now on, the network will be known as Audi TV.
Ray Romano, Everybody Loves Raymond.
Yeah, well, we all have those, but, you know, there's a time to express them and a time to just keep that crap inside.
Tony Shalhoub.
Wait a minute. Oh, my mistake. These are not birth control pills. These are Tic Tacs. These are little pink and green Tic Tac candies. But don't eat them. They're special.
Charlie Sheen. 2 and a Half Men.
A couple of dancing monkeys you could just haul out whenever it suited you. And when it didn't, you sent us off to boarding school or camp or that... kibbutz in Israel, where we got beat up because we weren't even Jewish!
And the actor goes to...
Tony Shalhoub.
This is Tony Shalhoub's second consecutive win for male actor in a comedy series.
Over here, Tony.
Thank you very much. I'm so proud to be among you, among this group. They asked us not to go through a whole long list of thank yous this year, but I just want to extend my gratitude to all of the guest actors who come on to series television. You know, as series regulars, our job is made so much easier to be in the head of the character week in and week out, as Jamie Foxx proved so much so well tonight. But for the guest actors who come into a show without any preparation, without any time to rehearse, their job is so much harder to capture the tone, to create a character, to work in harmony with actors and directors they've not worked with before. I want to extend my gratitude to them. Thank you all.
Ladies and gentlemen, Sandra Oh and Anthony LaPaglia.
Good evening. Television's funniest ladies enjoy a rich heritage that goes way back to a gal named Lucy.
And every year, a new name is added to that special family tree. Actors who can deliver a laugh with a well-timed line or bring down the house with simply a glance.
The nominees for Outstanding Female Actor in a Comedy Series are...
Terry Hatcher, Desperate Housewives.
I'm okay with me. I can walk down the street and hold my...
Patricia Heaton, Everybody Loves Raymond.
Everything she does comes from love.
I understand that you're upset.
Please don't make us take them back.
I'm sorry.
Is it money? Because we could pay more money.
Megan Mullally.
God
Will and Grace.
Give me the ability to play the piano or paint a picture or have compassion. But he did give me the ability to crack a walnut with my hoo-ha.
Sarah Jessica Parker, Sex and the City.
In Dior, so I decided that the more I purchased, the less they'd think of me as the American who fell in Dior.
I haven't had that much fun with your father in a long time.
Doris Roberts, Everybody Loves Raymond.
Dad, they got cheap booze there.
And the actor goes to...
Exciting, exciting.
Terry Hatcher.
This is Terry Hatcher's first Screen Actors Guild win. She's also nominated tonight for Ensemble in a Comedy Series.
Okay, it's really heavy. That's one thing. I sort of expect this, and look at this, all these amazing actors. I came to Los Angeles as a dancing extra in The Love Boat in 1985. And since then, I got to work with Christopher Guest and Kevin Bacon and Kevin Klein and Sally Field and Whoopi Goldberg and, a lot of movies and TV shows for really having no career a year ago. And I learned from all those people, and I am so proud to be a part of this group. I never thought I could even call myself an actor, and I want to thank you for letting me sort of rediscover myself, for giving me a chance to maybe get rid of old perceptions and be a part of this group of wonderful cast on this show with amazing writers and Jamie Denton and Andrew Bowen, my boyfriend and my daughter, who don't get all the press of all of the lovely housewives, but make me so great in those scenes. If it wasn't for you, I wouldn't be anywhere. And the same thing to all of you ladies. It's just the most wonderful job, and thank you very much.
Please welcome Paul Giamatti.
Thank you. Thank you. Two good buddies, one a divorced writer and connoisseur of the grape, the other an unemployed actor about to marry, journey up the California coast for a bachelor fling in Sideways, tonight's third feature film nominated for Ensemble Acting. The fun begins as the desperate duo strike up a friendship with two charming women, and the likable quartet soon becomes a catalyst for truth and self-discovery, as rich and promising as rare vintage wine.
Well, so shall we get some dessert?
Why don't we go back to my place? I've got wine, some insane cheeses, music, whatever.
Yeah. Waiter.
Ladies and gentlemen, Ellen DeGeneres.
I'm presenting the award for Outstanding Ensemble in a Comedy Series, and I like this category a lot because it's all about teamwork. And as you know, there's no I in teamwork, although there is a me, and and tame, and take, worm, wart, cream, but then you have to spell it with a K, and mork, like Mork and the Mindy, but I miss that show. Are they nominated? If so, good luck to the rest of you.
Cast of Arrested Development.
We're taking the plea.
We're going to trial, you're going to lose, and you're going to stay in there.
That's enough.
Nothing's enough. You'd think a man locked up in prison would be able to abstain. Your father with his disgusting tweaking. I couldn't breastfeed any of you kids because of that man.
Mother, what are you doing? You
still look fabulous.
Cast of Desperate Housewives.
I have to leave tomorrow. I can't leave him hanging.
I wish I would have known earlier. I would have arranged a sitter.
Dorn, I have to take Rex to his angiogram.
Hmm. Well, Meyer, what's your excuse?
I'm just, you know, busy stuff.
Cast of Everybody Loves Raymond.
We get the house. $26,000.
Whoa, why do you get that?
What do you care, Ray?
$26,000.
85 minutes.
Cast of Sex in the City.
New York City, circa now. I think it's romantic if someone offers me a seat on the subway.
That is romantic. We are just starved for real romance, and that is the sad truth.
I'm not starved. Smith is in L.A. for the week, and he calls me every night before he goes to sleep.
Phone sex doesn't count.
Cast of Will and Grace.
It smells so good in here.
God's sake, Grace, don't draw attention to your nose.
Now remember, everything you do here tonight is a reflection on me.
I understand completely, Will. Your large, shiny forehead needs some powder. I, on the other hand, look fantastic.
And the actor goes to the cast of Desperate Housewives.
Still in its first season, this is Desperate Housewives' first ensemble award for acting.
Good evening. We'd like to use this award to ring the death knell to reality television. The incredible success of Desperate Housewives begins and ends with one man, and that's Mr. Mark Cherry. He is actually in his office right now working, writing, and he is as kind and generous and ethical as he is talented, and we wanted to let you know that tonight. We want to thank our executive producers, Mr. Tom Spezialy and Michael Edelstein. The overworked and often underrecognized Mr. George Perkins. Is George here? All of our directors and writers who make our show all that it is. We would also, no actor stands on the stage without first gaining the support and confidence of a casting director. And we have two brilliant casting directors because they cast us. They are Junie Lowry Johnson and Scott Jenkinger. All you actors out there, if you do audition for our show, you will be treated well, you will be treated with respect, and when you leave, you will think, wow, that was almost like acting. Lastly, we too celebrate or share this award with every guest cast and day player who have graced our set with their talent, and to our Screen Actors Guild stand-ins, Rosie, Jenny, Patty, Sandra, Scott, Dawn, Don, Mark, and Eric, who runs the football pool. Thank you for this honor. God bless.
When the Screen Actors Guild Awards return, Mel Gibson and Julie Andrews present James Garner with the Life Achievement Award. TNT's presentation of the 11th Annual Screen Actors Guild Awards is brought to you by T-Mobile. Get more minutes, more features, more service. Please welcome Mel Gibson.
Lady Luck plays a part in every actor's life, and in 1947, she made an unexpected appearance at Hollywood High. The Janssen Company was scouting for a model to promote a new line of swimwear, men's swimwear, and they spotted and signed a 16-year-old Jim Bumgarner, an athletic, good-looking kid affectionately nicknamed Slick by his classmates. You remember that, Jim? I hope so. I don't. After the Korean War, Private Garner, I guess he stopped being a bum in the army, returned home decorated with two Purple Hearts. But before his tour of duty, Jim had already experienced the taste of acting on Broadway, performing with Henry Fonda in the Caine Mutiny Court Martial. Jim didn't have a single spoken word of dialogue in that play, but he learned to listen. And with Charles Laughton directing, what a wonderful education. Warner Brothers put him under contract in 1955, and soon Jim Garner became a household word, playing a cool dude named Maverick. He's been entertaining us ever since with award-winning work in television, commercials, feature films, each crafted with class, and the man's sheer likability. I want to mention that on two occasions, Jim eloquently served the Screen Actors Guild as vice president, just part of a career that spans 5 decades, marked by his authenticity, wisdom, and wit. On screen and off, he's one of our most beloved Mavericks, a real hero of mine and a true American original.
Hello. It's nice to see you again.
When I became an actor, it's kind of a long story. I didn't like what I was doing. I was working for my father laying carpets. I knew I didn't want to do that, so I hung around and hung around. And finally, I got a part in the series Cheyenne.
Well, I first met Jim and very casually in a restaurant on the Sunset Strip. And the next day at the studio, my boss, Bill Orr, said we needed some new faces for the new Cheyenne TV series, which was just about to start. Needless to say, he got the part, the small part, and a few weeks later, he had a 7-year contract with Warner Brothers.
Being under contract in those days, the studio owned you body and soul. I was doing Maverick for $500 a week.
Thank you, gentlemen. I give you a chance to get it back tomorrow.
Toward the Unknown, that was the first feature I was in. And Bill Holman told me one day he'd been to see Dailies, and he said, Jim, you got a big career ahead of you.
You better watch yourself, pal. This is the kind you'll wind up marrying. Don't worry, I'll keep my guard up.
And that really pumped me up. I thought, well, maybe I know a little bit of what I'm doing. I didn't, but I thought I did.
Jerry!
What? I don't think of myself as an actor, I think of myself as a reactor. Without somebody giving me something, it's hard to give back.
Your idea of this escape is to start another front, to foul up the Germans behind the lines. All right, that's fine, it's fine. But once we get past that barbed wire, once we have them looking all over Germany for us, that mission is accomplished.
I've been very fortunate to had some actors gave me a lot.
You're forever falling in love with men on their last nights of furlough. That's about the limit of your commitments. One night, a day, a month. You'd prefer lovers to husbands, hotels to home. You'd rather grieve than live.
I'm gonna snap your face, Charlie.
Go ahead, I won't hit you back. I'm a coward.
I don't like to see a cutaway from the actor to the stuntman, and it's obviously a stuntman. I never liked that. If you're gonna get too close, I was gonna do it myself.
Helen, Helen, wait! Helen!
It was good on screen, but boy, off screen, I was hurting.
You don't look much like a dean of admissions.
Oh, what do I look like?
You look like a truck driver in a suit.
You're a cop, huh?
No, what I am, Sonny, is about 50 pounds heavier and one hell of a lot meaner, so you better straighten up your act. I don't think I like you.
Do you think these two guys are mixed up together?
Yeah, could I keep this, Angel?
Oh, sure. Me and Jimmy go back a long ways together. We was in the pen together. We were both praying.
When I was in Rockford and I was working hard and doing all that, I was offered the job to do Polaroid commercials.
Polaroid's one step is the world's simplest camera. You just press the button, the sharp, clear colors develop in minutes.
Let's see it.
No.
Mariette Hartley and I were partners in it. Everybody thought we were married.
Okay, you can see it.
I don't want to.
Why not?
Cause.
You'll love it.
Okay.
Too late.
These men are on official duty, so why don't you just hold on to their bottles till its crisis dies down?
Well, I had a series that I was really fond of called Nichols. And it's really kind of my favorite because I love the era. I love the humor of it. Gosh, it was so much fun.
Remove your hands from the lady.
Sometimes when you least expect it, your hero arrives.
Acting, you know, is... be on time, know your words, hit your marks, and tell the truth. And that's what I try to do. I just try to stand up there and tell what I think the writer's trying to say.
Are you mocking me?
Well, we don't want you to get ruffled. Let's just say I was agreeing with you in a totally unusual way.
Unfortunately, when John Ritter died, the 8 Simple Rules, the television show, was kind of lost, and they don't know what they're going to do. And they had the idea to bring a grandfather in.
Hey, Dad, where you been?
Jogging. I'm amazed, number one, that I'm still at it.
Ah, so many pills. How sick are you?
Well, sickness has become a relative term for me. I think of it now as more a general wearing out process. The fact that I know I've given it my best shot, I never went in and just threw it away, just tossed it away. You can't do that. It's not fair, it's rude to your fellow actors, your producers, to the business. And every time you go in there and you're hired to do a job, do a job. Do the best you can, even if it's a piece of, even if it's not good. You know, do your best.
Ladies and gentlemen, Julie Andrews.
Isn't he the dishiest fellow you've ever seen? Sorry about that, Mel, but it's his evening, you know. I had the pleasure of working with Jim in 3 films, and from day one, I just fell in love with him. I lost my screen virginity to him in London, in the Americanization of Emily, and much later, I lost my manhood to him in Victor Victoria, with my husband, Blake Edwards, directing us, no less. And believe me, that's not easy. And sometime after that, I spent one special night with Jim, which was a movie for television that we did in freezing weather in Montreal. And Jim is always a gentleman, a joy to work with, a consummate professional, a devoted family man, and one of the all-time great actors and reactors. I treasure our friendship, and I love him dearly, as I know you all do. Come on.
On behalf of the Screen Actors Guild, it is my privilege, pleasure, and honor to present the Screen Actors Guild Award for Lifetime Achievement to Mr. James Garner.
Much of that, I get very emotional. Hello, actors. Well, of course, I'm humbled by this this evening. I don't know if I deserve this award, but please, if just for tonight, you'll forgive me if I act like I do. You look at the list of wonderful actors who have been recipients of this award. I'm not at all sure how I got here. I'm just so humbled to be a part of such a distinguished group. And, well, we actors, we seldom know how we are perceived by others. But this wonderful award lets me know, say, hey, Jim, you must have done something good. So to have actors think of me in these terms, and it touches me deep. In my heart. To all of my fellow actors and, of course, my lovely co-stars, leading ladies that I've had the pleasure of working with, I can only offer one grateful and astounded thank you to all of the people who have helped me along the way and brought me to this moment. I would be remiss if I didn't mentioned that the one person who has been every step of the way with me and my wife of 48 years, Lois. I love you, sweetheart, for all the support you've given me and a few other things. Oh, one more thing I would like to say. Actors are very special people, and I love each and every one of you. I have been a member of this guild for over 50 years, and it's a great guild. It's the best guild in the world. I'm proud to be part of it, and just remember, you take damn good care of it, okay? And now I get to go to work next week with my cast and crew of 8 Simple Rules and start on my second lifetime. Thank you so much. I love you all.
When we return, Kate Winslet presents the award for male actor in a supporting role and a message from Screen Actors Guild President Melissa Gilbert. TNT's presentation of the 11th Annual Screen Actors Guild Awards is brought to you by Listerine. You can handle it, germs can't. Please welcome the president of the Screen Actors Guild, Melissa Gilbert.
Tonight's Ensemble Awards are a perfect reminder that when we work together, the result is often more powerful than when we work alone, certainly in acting, but even in the face of natural disasters and war, we always rise to the occasion together. Screen Actors Guild is proud of the steps actors have taken to raise funds for tsunami victims overseas, and I am proud to say once again, our ceremony tonight is going out to America's men and women in uniform all over the globe. We hope it offers them a rest from their dangerous task. And once again, I am so honored to thank the other entertainment unions whose generosity to our guild makes it possible to honor the good works we all do together. Our gratitude to our very own large ensemble, the DGA, the WGA, the AFM, and AFTRA. We are colleagues who stand together when the chips are down, friends who help and protect one another, because we are truly part of one seamless fabric. And now, a little surprise. There's an actor who couldn't be here tonight, but he's been part of the Guild since it was born.
I joined the Screen Actors Guild in 1933, and I've been a member ever since. My name is Charles Lane, and I'm 100 years old, and I'm still an actor.
Ladies and gentlemen, Don Cheadle.
Tonight's fourth film nominated for ensemble acting is Hotel Rwanda. Thank you. I was honored to play Paul Rusesabagina, the diplomatic manager of a luxury hotel in Kigali. Without prejudice, Paul courageously sheltered hundreds of refugees from all sides during the 1994 Civil War. Our cast portrayed Paul's family, his friends, as well as the terrifying force that threatened them. We worked as a team, never forgetting the 1 million victims that the world, for the most part, chose to ignore.
To the hotel.
No!
Sir, please, don't touch the camera. We have the right to film.
No filming.
Go to the hotel.
No.
Go inside. Go inside the hotel. All of you.
Please welcome Kate Winslet.
The age range of our nominees for outstanding performance by a male actor in a supporting role is incredibly impressive. The youngest is 12 and the oldest is 76. But no matter what their age, all five actors have given extraordinary performances. Here are the nominees.
Thomas Hayden Church, Sideways.
Consult your doctor before using this product. Side effects may include oily discharge, hives, loss of appetite, low blood pressure. If you have diabetes or a history of kidney trouble, you're dead, asshole.
Jamie Foxx, Collateral.
If I don't pull it off, then
I will kill you.
You got 10 minutes. At 10:01, I drive to the hospital and execute your mother on my way out of town. Don't pretend indifference.
I can't do this.
Morgan Freeman, Million Dollar Baby.
Stop that fight. Should have saved my eye. Spends his life wishing he could take back that 109th fight.
James Garner, The Notebook.
Look, guys. That's my sweetheart in there. I'm not leaving her. This is my home now.
Freddie Highmore, Finding Neverland.
Short play. I just started writing. I haven't been able to stop. I thought she'd always be here.
And the actor goes too. Okay, a lot of envelope. Morgan Freeman.
Morgan Freeman was nominated in 1995 for his work in The Shawshank Redemption. This is his first Screen Actors Guild win.
Who is a long, tall stranger there? Maverick is his name. Riding the trail to who knows where. Luck is his companion. Gambling is his game. I want to thank anybody who I ever met. I want to thank Clint Eastwood and his entire family. I want to thank Hillary Swank, Al Ruddy, coming to us with this wonderful script. And I want to thank you all so much.
Ladies and gentlemen, Laura Linney.
During the past year, we said farewell to many talented friends and colleagues. Among them, an American president, a diminutive beauty who captured the affection of a gigantic beast, a musician who defined the world's soul, a beloved talk show host, and artists of such power and grace that their screen presence will forever inspire those of us who act. To all who enriched our lives, a final bow with heartfelt thanks.
Please welcome Sean Hayes.
Most female actors I know would rather not receive an award with the word SAG in it. The Screen Actors Guild nominees for Outstanding Female Actor in a Drama Series are...
Drea De Mateo, The Sopranos.
A year ago? I don't know. I was arrested.
For what? What are you talking about?
For drugs.
Edie Falco, The Sopranos.
Your best efforts. I have an attorney who is going to aggressively pursue my custody of AJ and also an equitable distribution of our assets.
Our assets?
Jennifer Garner, Alias.
Since that night, you've been missing for almost 2 years.
Allison Janney, The West Wing.
I never quite understood you, but you're extremely capable and you run this office like a Swiss watch and you're tall, which is reassuring. Leo may need you, and if he does, that's okay, but if he's willing to part with you, I hope you'll stay.
Christine Lahti, Jack and Bobby.
All I do every single day is care about you. You have no idea what I've given up for you, for both of you.
And the actor goes to Electra, Jennifer Garner.
This is Jennifer Garner's first Screen Actors Guild Award.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. My first job, Melissa Gilbert played my mom. I called her Laura every day in the makeup trailer. I practically called her Half Pint. It's so fun to be sitting with her. I've claimed James Garner for years as a relative. It's wonderful to be in this room and to be part of this union. And the day my parents accepted that I was an actor was the day that I told them, I get insurance. So thank you to SAG and thank you to all the actors that we work with on Alias, the background, my stunt double, Shauna Duggins, my stand-in, Nancy Wetzel, my incredible cast, the writers, ABC, everybody. We're so lucky to have this job. We have a blast. Thank you so, so much.
Ladies and gentlemen, Terry Hatcher and James Denton.
They play a doctor, a mafia boss, a New York detective, an FBI specialist, and a secret agent.
Five actors in five hit series who deliver grand slam action and intrigue week after week.
The nominees for Outstanding Performance by a Male Actor in a Drama Series are...
Hank Azaria, Huff.
You tell Melody the next time she pulls a stunt like this, I'll have her arrested for disturbing the peace. Now get out of here!
Look, I don't know any Melody, and Melody ain't suing you.
James Gandolfini, The Sopranos.
How about my 40 grand? You still out of the bird feeder. That should be plenty. You're such an investment genius.
You want this to get ugly, Tony? Because these guys live for that.
Oh, you think I don't?
Anthony LaPaglia, Without a Trace.
Enough! Enough! That's enough!
Jerry Orbach, Law and Order.
10 o'clock. The band went on about 11. What'd you do for that hour? Read a book?
Why is he talking to me like that?
Because you killed 23 people, Nick. That gets me a little agitated.
I told you.
What are you, some kind of sick bastard that likes to watch things burn?
Kiefer Sutherland, 24.
You're the one in trouble here. You're the one breaking the law.
You think I'm playing a game here with you? Hundreds of thousands of people's lives are on the line. You have no idea how far I'm willing to go to acquire your cooperation.
And the actor goes to Jerry Orbach.
Accepting on behalf of Jerry. Accepting on behalf of Jerry Orbach, his wife, Elaine Orbach.
Very heavy.
Oh,
very
no.
Heavy.
Oh, God. Oh, God. How bittersweet, but it's still sweet. Thank you. Thank all of you. God, if Jerry were here, he would be so articulate and so giving and loving and receiving all of you for this beautiful award. Jerry was an actor, and he loved actors. He loved kibitzing with them. He loved playing cards with them. He loved playing Scrabble with them. But he loved being with them. Jerry had a motto. He said, never leave a hit show. It was a good one. He did it for the audiences of Broadway for a good 35 years with all the major long-running shows that he did, Promises. Good Lord. The original Chicago, which that's where we met and fell in love. 42nd Street. On and on and on. And in between, oh, wonderful Dick Wolf said, would you consider Law and Order? And of course, it brought him back to his beloved Broadway, because he could spend time on and around Broadway. Oh, God, and it gave him the longest running show of his heart. He loved it. He stayed there till the end. And he always said, never leave a hit show. May you all never leave your hit show. Thank you so much. God, it's heavy. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Clint Eastwood.
Thank you. Well, it makes it easy for a director to, when you have a cast like Hilary Swank and Morgan Freeman. Congratulations, by the way, Morgan. But tonight's Million Dollar Baby is the fifth nominee. I almost forgot the name of this picture. the fifth nominee for ensemble cast. And it's a lot of people think it's a boxing movie, but it's actually a love story. And as far as I'm concerned, it's people searching for relationships. And I think it's also about a young girl who refuses against all odds to give up. So here we are.
What's reading?
What's she saying? I also know what you're reading. It's Yates. Keep your head back. Won't you talk a little Yates to her? Sure, what a treat that is. When the hell are they gonna get to her?
I'm okay, Frankie.
Ladies and and gentlemen, Glenn Close.
Whatever the medium, the specific chemistry generated by a particular group of actors is key to the success of a project. The nominees for outstanding performance by an ensemble in a drama series are...
Cast of 24.
Dad, I got Michelle in the line.
I want you to let Saunders catch you again.
What are you, crazy?
We have to let the exchange go down. It's the only way we're going to catch him.
You want me to give myself up?
Yes, the exchange site is secure. I'll send our people in as soon as we know he's there.
Chase, redirect three people now. Chase,
Chase, order. Don't!
Dad, stay out of this!
You are not in command here. Get him out of here now!
Cast of CSI, Crime Scene Investigation.
And other than hospitals, the only individual who's purchased one in the last year and a half in Las Vegas, Nevada, is Dr. Carl Benway.
We know the name of the butcher.
Benway?
Okay.
Cast of 6 Feet Under.
Hey, what happened to your face?
I got in a fight.
Good morning, morning glories. I hope we didn't keep any of you folks up last night.
They found Lisa's body. She's dead.
Cast of The Sopranos.
Tony's been away. It's been hard. But he's back now. For good. So welcome him.
Cast of The West Wing.
They think it's a massive heart attack.
You've got to keep him out of that job. He'll kill himself for you if you don't.
You're still here.
I'm still here.
The president knows, right?
Knows what?
He's going to have to bomb Palestinians.
What's the president doing? A summit? He's already got a Nobel Prize. What's he need a second one for?
And the actor goes to the cast of... CSI, Crime Scene Investigation.
Nominated for the past 3 years, this marks the first win for the cast of CSI.
Well, this is a shock. The only explanation for this is that somehow, in the last year, every one of you tried to act with rubber gloves and tweezers. Although I will have to say that when you share your close-up with carpet fibers, you're doing a little bit of ensemble acting. The best thing about being an actor is that we get to hang out with other actors. We enjoy being with each other every day. We care about each other. We're friends. And that's truly our reward. We're proud to be members of the Screen Actors Guild, the best private club in the world. And we would like to thank our Fellowship of Gypsies for this lovely award. Thank you. Peace.
When the Screen Actors Guild Awards return, find out who will win male and female actor in a leading role, plus Leonardo DiCaprio, Cate Blanchett, Johnny Depp, and Charlize Theron. Please welcome Johnny Depp.
Hi. The nominees for Outstanding Performance by a Female Actor in a Leading Role are...
Annette Bening, Being Julia.
I hate myself.
I'm a slut. I'm just a rotten bitch. Rotten through and through.
Nevertheless, you're a great actress.
Not tonight.
No, not tonight.
Catalina Sandino Moreno, Maria full of grace.
¿Usted se va a casar con alguien que, no ama? ¿Que no lo ama? Dígame cuántos meses, cuántos días pasarían antes de que usted se acostara con otra vieja.
Imelda Staunton, Vera Drake.
Why are we here?
Because of what I do.
What is it that you do, Mr. Drake?
I help young girls out.
Hilary Swank, Million Dollar Baby.
I'm gonna be a champ. I seen you looking at me.
Yeah, out of pity.
Don't you say that. Don't you say that if it ain't true.
Kate Winslet, Eternal Sunshine of the Spotless Mind.
Best. Maybe we can.
And the actor goes to Hilary Swank.
This is Hilary Swank's second Screen Actors Guild Award. Her first was for the female lead in Boys Don't Cry.
I am amazed, lucky, thankful, speechless, and quite frankly stunned to be a working actor. I thank my fellow SAG members for this incredible honor. This award means so much to me, and I also want to acknowledge my fellow nominees who inspire me to be a better actor. You know, I also can't believe I'm a working actor working with the legendary Clint Eastwood and the always amazing Morgan Freeman. I think one of the rarest qualities and most important qualities is the being able to believe in someone else. And Clint, your unwavering belief in me, I am just so thankful for that. I am thankful to you for reminding me to trust my instinct and allowing me to trust my instinct. And I am in such awe. It's hard enough to be an actor, and how you directed this picture while giving the performance of a lifetime, producing and composing, I bow down to you. You are a talent beyond compare, and if I'm half the person you are and half the talent you are when I'm 74, I will know I have accomplished something great. I want to thank Tom Rosenberg and Gary Lucchese for sending me this beautiful script, Al Ruddy, the wrapping up sign's coming, but you don't understand, we work so hard, please give me a moment to talk. Phyllis Huffman, our casting director. My trainers, Grant Roberts and Hector Roca, and Tanya McComas. Clint's telling me to wrap it up. My mom. You know what? My mom, for believing in me from the very beginning. So, anyway, I thank you for this great honor, and I want to also thank my husband for just putting up with me. Thank you.
Please welcome Kate Blanchett and Leonardo DiCaprio.
A massive family fortune and an ego to match give wing to The Aviator, tonight's final film nominated for Best Ensemble Cast.
The Aviator tells this true story of Howard Hughes, a brilliant eccentric who transformed commercial flight and took Hollywood along for the ride.
The cast recreates another era as we meet the colleagues Hughes motivated, the enemies he conquered,
and the glamorous stars who fell under his magnetic spell.
Thank you.
the future.
Please welcome Charlize Theron.
Wasn't my fault. The nominees for Outstanding Performance by a Male Actor in a Leading Role are...
Don Cheadle, Hotel Rwanda.
Most importantly, this cannot be a refugee camp. The Interahamwe believe that the Mikulin is a 4-star Sabina hotel. That is the only thing that is keeping us alive.
Johnny Depp, Finding Neverland.
I've not spoken about this before to anyone.
What's it like? Neverland.
One day I'll take you there.
Leonardo DiCaprio, The Aviator.
Find the Atlantic. For Christ's sakes, it just isn't fair. Look, he owns Pan Am. He owns Congress. He owns the Civil Aeronautics Board, but he does not own the sky.
Jamie Foxx, Ray.
When I walk out that door, I walk out alone in the dark. I'm trying to do something that ain't nobody ever done in music and business. But I can't do it if I'm alone everywhere I go. I don't want to be alone here, B. Not in my own home.
Paul Giamatti, Sideways.
It takes the time to understand piano's potential, can then coax it into its fullest expression.
And the actor goes to Jamie Foxx.
Jamie Foxx is nominated in 4 award categories tonight. This is his first win as an actor in a leading role.
We have to do it for Ray. Oh! 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 Yeah, you're ready. First of all, I just want to say thank you to SAG Awards, my peers, to everybody that voted for this. Thank you for Ray Charles for just living so complex and so interesting and making us just come together as everybody. I tell you this story. I was in D.C., And it was for the Black Caucus, and we screened this film, and a young black kid stood up, and he had a jersey on, and he had his bling bling on, and everybody was wondering, what is this kid gonna say? Because it was like that question and answering. And he said, Fox, do you think this might like give you a nod or something like that? And he said, a nod, and he was talking about Oscar nod or Screen Actors Guild, and it was beautiful to see the education that's going on with this film because everybody is getting on board with it, so thank you for that. Thank you for Taylor Hackett for taking a chance with an African-American film. Taylor, you're my director of the year, man, no matter what. Thank you for that beautiful cast that's sitting right over there on that table that can go with anybody. You guys are incredible to me, and I split this up and I share it with you right there at that table. Yeah. Jamie and Marcus King, my managers, CAA, my agents, Kim Hodges, Rick Kurtzman, Steve Smook, everybody, and to all the actors that I'm looking at in this crowd that I'm gonna get autographs from and pictures and everything, and so I can put them up on my wall so I can front and say, yeah, those are my good friends. And Denzel Washington. When I saw Denzel Washington, he was such an ambassador as an actor, and I met Denzel Washington a long time ago, and I hope he never, ever remembers how I met him, because I wasn't Jamie Foxx at the time. I was Eric Bishop. I was just a young comic in LA trying to come up, and the Roxbury was going off at the time. I don't know if anybody ever been to the Roxbury, but I could not get in for nothing. And I see Denzel come out, and I don't know if you know, but black people march when they get excited. And I saw Denzel, and I said, Denzel! And he took his elbow and stuck me right in the throat and said, hold on, hold on. What's going on? What's going on? And I told him how much I... And I'm sitting there with his elbow in my throat, and I'm trying to tell him that I really love what you do, dog. And from that moment all the way up to being in Venice, Italy, when Denzel calls me out of the room and says, come down to the front, I need to talk to you. And he said, I've been hearing some things. I don't want to scare you, but just keep doing what you're doing. If you win or if you lose, keep walking in the same direction. I'm walking, D.
When the Screen Actors Guild Awards continues, Tim Robbins reveals the winner for Cast of a Motion Picture. TNT's presentation of the 11th Annual Screen Actors Guild Awards is brought to you by L'Oreal Paris, because you're worth it. Ladies and gentlemen, Tim Robbins.
Throughout the evening, you've seen moments from this year's six films nominated for Outstanding Ensemble Cast in a Feature Film. Once again, they are The Aviator, Finding Neverland, Hotel Rwanda, Million Dollar Baby, Ray, Sideways. Six accomplished casts in six great pictures. And the actor goes to the cast of Sideways.
Such a great ride, and this has been such a great experience to be here with all fellow actors. To Paul Giamatti, the center of our ensemble, thank you so much. This has been such a pure filmmaking experience, and it's for a variety of reasons, because everyone was working at their best. And thank you to our great casting director, John Jackson, who brought us Mary Louise Burke and Jessica Hecht and Patrick Gallagher, the great and naked MC Gainey. The naked man. To Fox, Searchlight, Mr. G, and Peter Rice, Claudia Lewis, who supported this film tremendously, and all the Foxy ladies at Fox who support us. And mostly to our great producer, Michael London, and because they never questioned the director's vision to cast who he wanted. And I thank you guys for that, because it doesn't happen all the time. And of course, to our great visionary director, Alexander Payne, who is in Sweden right now. Hi, honey. And to Jim Taylor, who wrote such a beautiful script, which is like manna from heaven for all actors. For Alexander Payne, the director, who saw in each one of us something that that most people don't usually see. So thank you for giving us the shot, and thank you for voting for us. Thank you.
You might want to frame this and give it to Alex. Congratulations to all of our outstanding actors, and thank you for help celebrating this with us. Good night, everybody.
11th Annual Screen Actors Guild Awards. This is Ellen Kay. Nominees for tonight's awards were selected by nationwide random samples of Screen Actors Guild members, and winners were chosen from ballots sent to the entire active membership of Screen Actors Guild. The outcome was determined and verified by the elections firm, Integrity Voting Systems. The final results were placed in sealed envelopes and revealed on tonight's show. United is proud to be the official airline of the 11th Annual Screen Actors Guild Awards.